Hello YouTube, this is Gavin Animator, and welcome back to my playthrough of Gray. Okay, so we left off, I got a little stuck. I have to find a code to the door. Yeah. I haven't really checked a lot in this part. Oh, wait. Oh! Sweet. Wow. Surprised that isn't blurry. Okay, so... Alright. Hang on, I'm gonna write this down somewhere. I'm glad I found this right when I pressed record. Okay. Hang on. Alright. So, let's see here. 4, 9, 8, 2, 3. Alright. It's easier for me to write down than trying to just remember. Because I'm bad at doing that. Wait. Was the door down here? I forget. I haven't played this since last night, so. And, oh, yeah, right, it's over here. Okay. Let's see here. 4, 9, 8, 2, 3. Yes! Oh, what the? Really? Didn't mean to do that. Jesus. Oh, come on, I can't bash that open. I'm at the hospital, I'm sure there's first aid in here. I can restore my health. Oh wait, what? Oh. Oops. 6, 5, 2, 0, 6. Alright. Can I pick up these chairs? Oh, I gotta climb. Hang on. Whoa. What's in here? Yes! Yes! Full health. Alright. Alright. Yeah. Okay, so now I gotta go back. Whoa. That is messed up. You got a scissor and a knife in your eyeballs. That's not good. That is not a good thing. Yeah, this guy's a little insane. From here. Oh. I knew that. Oh. Is it me or the other? Am I thinking of Silent Hill? What I was trying to say, is it me, or is Does this look... God dang it, stop interrupting me! Oh, really? Oh, you're the... Oh, you're not disappearing. Okay. So, as I was saying, is it me, or does this look a lot like Silent Hill? I'm at down to half health already? Seriously? It's only a few seconds ago when I had full health. These are some strong thingies. Strong monsters. These guys are tough. Breakable? Oh, they're bricks.
They must have moved everything
God.
In the basement during construction.
God dang it. Shut up, okay? I'm jumpy, okay? Don't judge me. Getting scared of myself now. God dang it, why aren't these ever openable? Alright. I think that's everything over here. So where do I go from here? It's a question that I've insane for a while. This doorway is boarded up by a bunch of brick walls, or a brick wall. I like how it wasn't even in front of that wall anymore as I was saying that. Let's see. This is back where I came from. Oh, wait. Oh, okay. Let's see here. So now what? So, oh yeah. I'll find the truth in the basement. I forgot about that. Huh. I was about to say Barney, but he's purple. Well, I mean, there was a green dinosaur in that show, so I guess that could kind of work. Don't question why I know that. I have no freaking clue. Alright. So, I'm stuck. So, Seriously? Nothing? Man. Dang it. Where am I supposed to go? Whoa. God. Frame droppage. Seriously. I swear. This looks a lot like something you'd see in Silent Hill. If I'm not mistaken. God. Wait, what? Oh. Can I interact with this? Nope. Oh, so. Oh, it does make a sound when I'm clicking out in the air. That's something I just noticed. Apologies. Tile. Oh. Oh, wait a second. Okay. Why would that be? Why would it tell me to go there up here? I don't know. But I think I know. It looks like it's coming from the first floor. Oh, wrong way. The first floor. Well, wait. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is it. This is it. This is it. Yes. Oh, there we go. Okay. Gotta break everyone. Oh. Wow, that's a lot of reading. Live a normal life. Wait, what? Hey, guys. So, the transition to the next map wouldn't work. And, like I checked the files and nothing seemed to be wrong, and whenever I tried to load the next map manually, it worked, but my stuff wasn't with me, so I was just like, screw it, let's just load the hardcore version of this map. Yeah, whatever. I was told that the good ending was on this map anyway. So. But shut up! Don't judge me. If I can't do it on normal, I can definitely not do it on hardcore. Yeah, screw these guys. Not dealing with them. Yeah. If you play it on hardcore, you get the good ending, is what I've heard. Jeez. It's still scaring me. Gotta open it somehow. Don't do that. What is this supposed to do? I don't know. But yeah. But yeah, normal mode is like impossible for me. I am not, like I said, I'm not MLG material. What the heck? They're still scaring me. How is this possible? Okay, nothing here. So I gotta open that door somehow, apparently. Don't like that noise. Yeah, this is definitely Silent Hill. Isk. I don't know why I never mentioned anything about the body bags, because they look like something you'd see in Silent Hill as well. No. Ow. Hurt. Jesus. So, how am I gonna get this to work? Wait, what? Oh. Hi there. I see the stuff items in the background, so I'm just gonna kill you even though you're not even moving. Yeah. It's... Trust me. I don't have AI disabled. The thing there... It's just, It's just a map error, and that the text is just a bug from before. Oh, I still have the codes. Really? Or 60256? Six, six. I don't know. I was thinking, like, put the numbers in order. Ow. That's what the bandages are for. Alright. Doing. I don't know. Ah! Stop moving me all over the place. Those masks are still creepy. They still bring me creepy memories. Or give me, not bring me. They don't. Think you can't bring memories. You can only give memories. I think. God. They're not even. They're not even disenable. I mean, the map isn't even working right. Or but I'm still getting scared by them. What? Okay, apparently it's open now. This seems rather peaceful. Oh wow. Lighting is really good in this mod. The graphics. And the colors. Wow. This looks really nice. Wow. I like the music as well. It's really nice music. Oh, cool. Little benches. Oh, yeah. Oh, I want to go. Wow. Just looped. Alright. I'm gonna explore just for a little bit. Cause I like this. I'm interested. I know this guy is insane and all, but it's not always you get to see these nice colors. Okay, I think that's all I'm able to see, so. Walls and floors and made it a clean, healthy shine. There was a sense of well-being about the place that gave me a great sense of reassurance. I was here to heal, and this seemed like the best place to do so. Gray Anderson.
entire family history is in these documents. Why does the hospital have all this? Why were they interested in us? It says here in the documents that in 1986, Steve and Jen, my parents, were married. Soon after, they moved into a small town away from the city's pollution called Bright Woods, hoping for a peaceful life for their soon-to-be children. My father used to work as a surgeon in the city, but now had to work at the local hospital for a much lower pay. My mother tried to get a job to help support his new salary, but was unable to. In 1989, my sister, Anita, was born. Anita goes to the city school and is bullied aggressively, frequently coming home in tears. My parents can't afford to send her anywhere else, bullying or not. In 1997, my mother is pregnant again with another daughter. Shortly after giving birth to Claire, Anita suffers a fatal fall on a school trip. It was no accident. But with little evidence other than a broken kid's wagon that she was tripped with, that every child on that trip had played on, there was no one to pin the blame onto. I think I know who did it to her, though. And that's been taken care of. Anita was rushed to Bright Woods Hospital, where Steve was one of the few surgeons available to work on her. While it was against hospital policy to allow staff to work on their family members, they had no choice. Anita dies in the hospital, under the care of our father, driving my father into a deep depression which eventually cost him his job at the hospital. In late 1998, my father finally completely breaks down, believing that his family has no future anymore. He decides to take out the rest of the family with him in a crazed suicidal state, successfully murdering Claire with a kitchen knife. He fails to kill my mother, who then calls the cops. Early 1999, Steve is admitted to Suzanne Cross Hospital, where he spends the rest of his life under review by Dr. Hammond Heath, who believes Steve's troubles are hereditary and that a lobotomy may be able to save his troubled mind. After the lobotomy, Steve suffers multiple seizures and lives out the rest of his life in a cell in a zombie-like state. Jen, my mother, finds out she is pregnant the same year. This time it's a baby boy, Steve's baby boy. Me. My mother worries about my future, knowing I will have no father to raise me, as well as fearing what I could become. Unable to afford the home she's living in anymore, she moves to an apartment in the same town. During the regular screenings and health checkups for the birth of myself, my mother finds out she has first-stage spinal cancer. I was born late 1999. My mother gives me the name Gray, knowing both her fate and mine to come. After 10 years of suffering and chemotherapy, as well as hundreds of thousands of dollars of debt, my mother dies, leaving the house to the bank and me to live the rest of my childhood in an orphanage. In 2019, I left the orphanage for the last time, becoming a car mechanic with low pay, but just enough to move into the ghetto part of the city. After about a year of work, I started to hate my job, my boss, those around me, and me. I start making simple mistakes, being lazy. Early May, I made a mistake while moving some heavy equipment, permanently crippling a coworker. I crippled him and hid my mistake from the others. I can't take working here anymore. Ever since this incident, everything just feels wrong. Everything has gone insane. After a fucked up decision and an argument with my boss, I grabbed a knife from the tools and stabbed him. I killed him. I went to the bar to wash the blood of my hands, to get rid of it. Months down the line, and I'm now free to roam outside for hours at a day. They let me fix things up with the janitor around the building. I've been getting better, they told me. Things are starting to look up for me. But what I did to her, to them, I can't leave this all behind me. It is something I will bear with me for the rest of my life. I still have a long time left in this hospital. But maybe one day, I will have my own place to call home. My own family.
Wow. So, I've lived in that hospital all this time. Wow. Wow. Okay. So, I guess that was it. Man. Wow. So, first of all, that was an incredible mod. Even though I've been through all that trouble, that was phenomenal. I highly recommend it. I love the graphics, how much modification they've put into that mod. That was just that was awesome. Great job. Done an incredible job. Time crab, isn't that the thanks for playing, thank you for making it. I highly enjoyed it. Wow. So guess I was in that sanatorium all this time, and I was just like, I was just like hallucinating, like imagining this screwed up I'm not sure why I can't talk right now. Well, yeah, what I'm trying to say is that I think what was going on is that I was in this mental institution all this time, and ever since I've killed my boss, I went crazy, and then they took me to that sanatorium, and where I live the rest of my life, or this is just what I'm piecing together. I might be right or wrong on this, but then he was like imagining this. He was reimagining everything that happened in a screwed up way. So, in really, really messed up way. Yeah. So yeah, that was gray. But yeah, incredible job. So, hope you guys enjoyed this series. If you did, be sure to give it a like, add your favorites, share it with your friends on Facebook or Twitter for support. It's very appreciative. And I will see you next time with some more awesome game mods like these, or games. So yeah, see you next time. Peace in.